Hi, good afternoon. I welcome you, every one of you, for this session. Name it as Spoken English, Mastering Spoken English. My title is about From Broken English to Spoken English for Fluent English, Tips and Techniques. So what is the major aim of this presentation in the sense? I'm going to tell you what are the secrets behind mastering any language. Mastering any language, that is a spoken English, a spoken Hindi or whatever it may be. But I have primarily taken English as the primary language. So particularly students, if you take students, scholars, graduates, right, or people who are all in working environment, they want to master English. Why? Because English is a global language. So what I'm going to tell you is, I'm going to tell you about why you get struggled to speak English, right? Even though you are from matriculation, even your schooling is in English medium, you can see plenty of students still struggling with how to speak fluently. So they are doing plenty of other things, like attending spoken English classes. Dedicatedly, they go and learn. But even though they are spending their time in the spoken English class, they are not able to do. Someone may interestedly ask some questions like, sir, I am English medium only, but I am still not able to speak fluently, sir. What is the reason? You can ask me the question. So I'm going to addressing all these issues, where you struggle, why is such a struggle for you to speak in English, what are the ways the native English people do, or native regional language people do, or English language people do to speak in English, what the traditional spoken English classes do, because they are doing some mistakes which not enable the people who are attending that classes are able to speak in English. So this is what my secret. So in the entire session, I'm going to speak to you about what is wrong with the traditional coaching centers, and what is the problem with the school, matriculation school. Even though it teaches in the English, still a lot of students are not able to speak in English. What is the reason? If you are a regional language familiar students, but you are new to the English, how you can speedily, quickly mastering spoken English? Such a things I am going to tell you. Simple tips and techniques I am going to tell you. That is a wonderful techniques derived for experts. So if you attend this session, you come to know about what are the tools and techniques you need to do so that you can master. So title is From Broken English to Spoken English for Fluent English, Tips and Techniques, Secrets Revealed. In this spoken English, still you can see plenty of people have a self-gullity of like, I am not able to speak English, and they feel shame and they don't speak. That is the reason, main reason why they are failed to speak. Okay, but that's not a true thing. Even the experts also struggling to speak in English, and a lot of comedy happens. Okay, we will discuss each and everything clearly, and you can easily understand what is the reason behind that. What I'm going to present you in the sense, what's my aim in the sense, that's what I'm going to give you, tips and techniques for mastering spoken English. And what is the outcome in the sense, if you are attending my presentation, and my tools and techniques, ideas, guidelines will help you to master the English. Okay, next, background. What is the traditional problem, current problem in spoken English? I am, sir, attending a plenty of spoken English classes, sir, spoken English books also I am studying, sir, Rapitex books I am studying, sir, I know English, sir, but I am not able to speak English. If these are all the things in your mind, that's what background, what's the problem? Why conventional methods not works? Traditional method in the sense, see, suppose if you go to a spoken English class, they tell something like grammar you have to master. and they give you a practice for writing and some things they used to do, but still the students are not able to master the spoken English. What's the problem? Even if you are studying a matriculation school from 1st to 12th standard also, still the students are not able to speak English in a good way, but they can understand, but they are not able to speak up very quickly. What is the reason? What are the ideas and the solutions are available so that you can master the English? This is what I'm going to speak in this. Ideas are solutions. The areas one need to concentrate. What are the tools and techniques you should master? And what are the practices you have to do so that you can master presenting, like speaking in English? Now, and if you are interested, you can join the particular place where I learned such a techniques. So aim or objective is very simple: to provide the tools and direction to improve English fluency. Specifically telling, I'm going to tell you how to gain the skill of dealing with hesitation while speaking English. See, you can see like a frontier people, when they say used to speak, they hesitate a lot. That is the reason they are not able to speak. So as they are not able to speak, what really happens in the sense, they keep their mouth mum, automatically they have the fear, hesitation, and they don't speak. And I'm going to tell you how to convert your knowledge of everyday English vocabulary and structures into your real mastery of spontaneous speech building skill, and to get free of urge to fall back on your mother tongue. Mother tongue. Suppose your mother tongue regional language is Hindi or Tamil, then why you are not able to master other languages? And gain the skill of composing what you want to say in English and to say it at the same time. Okay. And how to train your organs of speech to work smoothly. Don't forget, your organ plays a vital role, because you should get familiar with the particular words that you are going to utter. I'm going to tell you what you need to do so that your organs gets familiar. Particularly tongue is the organ that gets familiar, should get familiar with the words that you are speaking. If you fail to train by tongue, then you are not able to speak up. Even you can have English nuclei like where have you been? Let's fuel it. Hi dudes, good morning class. These are all some of the words already we are used many times, so tongue get suppled so it can speak. If you ever speak in English and you try to speak, this is what a hesitation. That's what how to train your organs of speech to work smoothly. So as I told you earlier, outcomes of this one is, upon the completion of the session, this session help one to get an excellent command of fluent English on one own. One might never be at a loss for fluent speech. Okay, background, let's see. So first of all, we should know about what is language. Why? Because most of the people still have urge that speaking in English is very proud, right? It's an image. They have such an opinion, but nothing like that. Language is, after all, a communication tool used to say the truth. What is language? Language is a tool used to show the truth. Any, you cannot say English is the better language, regional language is worst. No. Language is only a communication tool used to show the truth. So convey the truth or convey your ideas, whatever the thing. It's a communication tool merely. Then why such a hype for English? Because it is a global as well as the professional language. So no go, you need to master it. You need to master it. So this is what the major aim of this session. So global professional language English. So you need to master how to speak in English fluently, so that only your communication skill will get increased, and that placement opportunities also will get increased. You may ask a question. You may ask the question, sir, I feel ashamed to speak in English, sir. I'm not able to speak. I feel like something very terrible to speak in English, sir. I feel shamed. But you need not to get ashamed, because because of a broken English, because of not able to speak, you need not to get yourself guilt. That mistakes, not able to speak in English, mistakes not only happen to you. It happens to even president level also. I'm going to narrate the particular story that I'm going to tell about what happened between two presidents, Chinese president as well as US president, decade ago. Okay, once there was a meeting scheduled between US President Barack Obama and the Chinese president, interaction incident. So they need to meet with one another. So Chinese president is getting trained by their people, like how he had to interact with Barack Obama. So they teach Chinese presidents like as follows. Sir, when Barack Obama comes, you have to ask about how are you. Then he will say, I'm doing good. How do you do? He will say. Then you have to say, me too. Okay. What is the schedule? Chinese president has to open up and ask Barack Obama handshake, and has to ask like, how are you? How are you? Okay. Then Barack Obama, it is expected that Barack Obama will respond like, yeah, I am doing good. How do you do? Okay, if he asks, how do you do, and I am fine, he Chinese president also has to say like, yeah, me too. Myself also doing good. This is what the interaction. You know what happened with in the particular incident? Barack Obama came to China, and Chinese president, instead of asking how are you, he asked, who are you? So in order to overcome that wrong interaction, Barack Obama handled the situation like, for the particular question, who are you? Barack Obama said, I am Mitchell's husband. Because Mitchell is Barack Obama's wife. You know what happened, such a comedy. Then Chinese president, as per the preparation, Chinese president, what has to do? He has to say like, me too. So that incident somewhat went wrong. Why I am telling you is because you people can feel like, sir, I am not able to speak in English, sir. I feel ashamed. I am not able to answer in the interview. Sir, I am a Tamil medium. A lot of things available in their heart and mind, they are not speaking. Not only for this president level, in a plenty of places you can see a broken English and hesitation in English. Let us see such a things. See, these are all some of the conversation happened all over the globe somewhere, but it should be you should understand such a conversation so that you will get courage, faith that you can also speak English. Say once one of the person, important VIP, said the broken English. I went German, my friend married, I enjoyed. Meaning is entirely different. This is a broken English. Okay, but the interesting thing is, even if it is not wrong, if you speak in broken English, day by day, you will get to the upliftment of a spoken English. But if you not open up your mouth to speak, that is the problem. Okay, I went German, my friend married, I enjoyed. Then another conversation like, see, I was going on the road in car, suddenly mutton jump onto the road. See, actually he want to say in the sense, I was going on the road in the car, suddenly goat jump onto the road. This is what he would like to convey, but he don't recall goat. So instead of that, he said mutton jump onto the road. Once the Australian university has come to one of the college for MOE in the year 2004. I still remember the chairperson of the particular college while addressing, he said the particular person like soil of the sun. Soil of the sun means there is no meaning of soil of the sun, right? Like, see, he want to say something, but that goes in another way. So people have blown the top with a heavy laugh. So the same chairperson once when he delivering, he said the following thing. Today is the MGR birthday. Next month is Margali month, Ayyappan birthday. Broken English. See, another comedy. See, simply see,
I have 400 illegal daughters and 500 illegal son of first year. He is the chairman of the college, and he would like to convey like all the students are his daughters and sons. He want to say. So what he has to do? He say illegal daughters and illegal son. Means the meaning is entirely different. That's what he says. I have 400 illegal daughters and 500 illegal sons of first years. While punishing students, you can see some of the comedy, that broken English. You rotate the ground 4 times. We cannot rotate the ground. He has to ride the ground 4 times. He instead what he said in the sense, rotate the ground 4 times. How he can rotate the ground? Okay, see, this is another interesting comedy. Look at this. You go and understand the tree. So you go and stand under the tree is the correct conversation. But he said, you go and understand the tree. So broken English. You three of you stand together separately. How it is possible? Stand together, then separately. How it is possible? Right, this is broken English. Then one of the broken English, see, why are you late? Say yes or no. Even these sort of conversational broken English, you can see at your faculty level and chairperson level, secretary, and a lot of people also. You can always see the this sort of broken English and hesitation to spoken in spoken English, and the feel gullity of not able to speak in English. Such a hesitation, this you can see. Okay, one can ask me the question like, why traditional methods not works? Sir, I able to study in English, sir. Sir, I am from first standard to 12th standard. I am English only, sir. English medium only, sir. Sir, I went to spoken English class, sir. I studied grammar. I know how to write in letter, but I am not able to speak in English, sir. What is the reason, sir? So these are all the things generally always flash in every guy's mind. But what wrong in the conventional method? In the conventional method, in the school, they didn't teach you about spoken English. They have only given idea about written English. You can simply, you can recall your school days. They only teach you how to write from the exam point of view, memorizing and writing. They ever taught you about how to spoken English, speak in English? That is one of the reason why even if you are from the matriculation level, you are not able to speak. That's what the difference between spoken English versus written English. Learned at the school, college, written English, not spoken English. What is another trouble? What is another methodology, traditional methodology that we use not works? When you speak, you try to copy the style of written English. But the spoken English as well as the written English is entirely different. Say for an example, when you write an English, you should follow the grammar. However, when you speak in English, you need not to follow that grammar. What you can do is you can speak not continuously. You can speak in broken English also. When the bus will come, instead, the bus when come. This is also a conversation. But in written English, it is not grammatically correct. It is wrong. But in spoken English, this is correct. Even the native English people also speak in the following way only. So what we really do in the sense, we try to speak as we write in the letter. So what really happens, we try to translate it as it is. As it is, we try to speak, but that's not able to happen. So what happens at that time in the sense, we start thinking in terms of written English grammar, written English usage, and written English vocabulary. So this is the mistake. Next, we try to speak in terms of translating. That is English and your mother language, like a regional language. Then you try to speak in English. So the translations, no, that happens, but that's not really happens in the native place. So that's why it's not work. And you get lost. You try hard to complete whatever you say into perfectly formed sentences. What do you want to do in the sense? You want to perfectly form the sentence. You want to speak in a perfectly formed sentence. But that's not happens in a true conversational English. Even the native speaker also not perfectly speak. Okay. because you are under the impression that they are the true units of speech, and you end up gasping in the middle and you find it impossible to speak on without faltering. Means struggling. They would not sound natural. So when we try to speak in a translation manner in this way, you can see like this is sound unnatural. They would sound as if they were reading, which leads to broken English becomes their habit. Why conventional method not works? Because we are learning from heart. We are learning from heart. Impossible say CDs and cassettes are not helpful. So because you are learning by heart, you are not learning from your mouth, because the tongue plays a vital role in mastering this one, right? So analogy, Max practicing by heart and workout. See, suppose Max, you ever work out by using paper pen and you simply everything mug it up and you try to solve it in the exam. Will it work? Say, will it work? No, it won't work. Right, the same thing is true for here too. Even if you are the matriculation students from the schooling, from first standard to 12th standard, you only know how to mug up and to write. So your tongue is not get familiar with English, and you ever try to speak, so when you call to speak, it flatters, it hesitates. Okay, next, translation is another traditional method we used to do, but not works. Translation impossible. You won't be able to speak English fluently by translating. Translating in the sense, suppose you are speaking with some English person, he speaks, in your mind you try to convert into your regional language. Afterwards, the regional language is converted. You try to convert the regional language into English and you try to speak. It won't work because you try to translate. Translating from English to Tamil not works as it is. You can never achieve fluency in English through any other language. Organs of speech not cooperative. This is a very important thing. See, your tongue should first of all get familiar with your brain, the language. If you can able to speak in your regional language, because from the childhood itself you practiced yourself n number of times, and now so the tongue gets suppled with your mother tongue and simply speaks. But you have ever spoken in English and only you know how to write, mug it up and writing English only, then you try to speak, it won't work. Say for an example, in our regional language, there are certain letters are there, la, right? So it is very hard to native people, English people or other language people to utter. Why? Because the tongue is not get suppled. The same thing is true here too. Because your tongue is not get suppled with speaking in English, so it's not works. The muscle of organs of speech are in the habit of moving and bending regularly in certain set patterns to suit the demands of your mother tongue. They fight shy of working in a different way. What problem? The muscle of organs of speech are in the habit of moving and bending regularly in certain set of patterns to suit the demands of your mother tongue. They fight shy of working in a different way to suit the demands of the English language. So we come to know about what is the problem with the traditional methodology, right? And what is the solution so that I can adapt and can master speaking English? So these are all some of the solutions I'm going to tell you. I want to master English. What to do? One, you may ask, should I master the grammar of the language? This is where most of the spoken English classes fails. This is where our matriculation classes also fails. See, let me ask you a very simplest question. Suppose take a farmer, illiterate farmer. Take a kids, right? Kids, after 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 years, without knowing any grammar, it can be able to speak. Am I right? Okay. Take a illiterate farmer. He ever went to school, but without knowing grammar or without knowing how to write, he can able to speak. How it is possible? Because he only repeats, he only memorizes, he repeats, he gets suppled with the words, frequently used words, nuclei, language nuclei. He is very familiar. If he is a English farmer, illiterate farmer, then he knows certain contextual terms. Where have you been? Had your food? How are you? Hello, hi, let's fuel it. Where were you? Right? Hi guys. These are all some of the language nuclei he learned from others, so he repeat as it is. So he is not aware of max, he not aware of all the dictionary words he has ever mastered, and he ever used to write in that page, right? So mastering grammar, no need for spoken English, because spoken English is not depending on grammar. Okay, real thing, what happens for kids and illiterate speak without mastering grammar and so on? You can know some other people like Baroda master Chef, right? They go to other state and they come after 2 years or 3 years, they used to speak in Hindi. You get surprised by how they are able to speak without knowing grammar, without knowing how to write. The guy, illiterate guy, Chef Baroda master, can able to speak in Hindi, regional language. How it is possible? Because certain keywords, certain regional language, here English language nuclei frequently used. Say for an example, hello, phone call, hello sir, I am so and so speaking, how are you? These are all most frequently used words and contextual. You need not to know all the sentences as well as the words present in English. You need to only concentrate on the context level. If it is a college, you are a teacher, you need to have a contextual words, sentences only, and so on. So this is what you need to understand, where that spoken English class fails. So what is the solution? In the sense, learn words in context, as outside context words are meaningless. Learn words in context, as outside context words are meaningless. Say for an example, suppose English has around 3 lakh words, then you need not to master all the words. Why? Because you are going to use some of the frequently used words only. For that, you need not to study a dictionary. You need not to study a dictionary. That is a waste, no? Some people used to study from dictionary. Someone give idea about the study dictionary. Nothing you can learn from the dictionary. You can refer the dictionary for any of the particular word, right? Learn words in context. Say for an example, suppose you are the engineering student, you need not to master all the words, sentences related with the medical terms, with the financial terms, financial words, and so on. You have to only know about some engineering related words only. As a common person, what you need to do is certain words only you need to master, because you have to interact with other people. So this is what, learn words in context, as outside context words are meaningless. Suppose the 3-4 lakh words are there, in your daily life you are not going to use more than 2000 words, right? Merely 100 sentences, not more than 100 sentences you are not going to use it. So you need to first of all know those words, those sentences. You need to practice by tongue. If you are not able to practice it by tongue, you are not able to speak ever. Similar like max only. If you ever work it out in the paper pencil and you simply mug it up, everything in terms of mug it up only, then you can able to write. Can you able to solve the problem in the examination? No, not possible. Same thing. Teaching your tongue and speech rhythm. In English related context, certain words are some tougher to use it. Say for an example, won't be, don't you, have you, haven't you, These are all some of the things that you need to master it, because those are all frequently comes. Your tongue should get suppled. That's what teaching your tongue and speech rhythm. Say for an example, let us see some contextual conversational in English. So say for an example, telephonic conversation. What really happens in this? And could I ask who is calling, please? See, this is in the regional language also we use it to ask, right? Similarly, I'm sorry, he is not here today. Can I take a message? See, this is a sentence used in a phone conversational. Can I take a message? Sorry, he is not available. Grammar, if it is wrong and the sentences is not continuous, not exactly correct, not a problem, because this is what we used to speak in a regular day also. Could I ask who is calling, please? Instead, may I know who are you? Can you tell me who are you? Who is calling? You? Any replaceable terms can be used, right? Would you mind speaking up a bit? Sir, can you speak a little bit louder? I cannot hear you very well. I can't hear you. So there is no strict English. So what you need to do is you need to get practice. Let us see some more conversational English. Classroom, suppose if you want to see like classroom conversational English, then I didn't know it was due today. I won't start until everyone is quiet. This is faculty can use. I won't start. See, that thing to be trained, won't. You should utter it, won't. I won't. I didn't. He doesn't. She doesn't. I won't start until everyone is quiet. Until everyone is quiet. Settle down, please. Settle down, please. You can see like you have to start this sort of conversational English from one word sentence, two word sentence, three word sentence, four word sentence, five word sentence, six word sentence. Do you get them a point? See, look at this. Settle down, please. Is a three word sentence. You have to start your journey from one word sentence. Hi, hello, dude. Where to? Hello. Hope you do. Hope you do well. Regards. Could you? Can I? May I? May I help? Shall we? Two word sentence, one word sentence. You can start your journey from this way and you can start moving. Three word sentence, four word sentence, five word sentence, six word sentence, and so on. Does everyone have their lunch? Because this is a general conversation only. Does everyone have their lunch? A teacher may ask a question. Does everyone have their lunch? Later on, you can convert into, does everyone have their breakfast? Does everyone have your dinner? So in this way, you can change. Or Ramesh, had your food? So because this is not that spoken English need not be exactly grammatical oriented. It can be in somewhat shifted. Sir, where can I get these sort of conversational nuclei? See, you can use a Google search engine to get a telephonic conversational English, classroom conversational English, college conversational English, court conversational English, right? Friends conversational English, family conversational English, child conversational English. In this way, if you give, you will get a plenty of these sort of sentences, and you can start reading it. You can utter it louder so that your tongue get practiced. The solution, there are plenty of solutions helps you to master spoken English. The one is subtitle movies. Nowadays, you can see most of the movies comes with the English subtitle. And you can see like always there is a text they have given. Like you can start memorize it. You can start utter it. Or you can memorize it and you can use it in the real world and so on. See, plenty of movies you can see. While seeing the movie, you can read it. It gives you the short information. What are you doing? Where to? Let us fuel it. She stole my money. Who are you? Where have you been? These sort of conversational English you need to master, not the sentences, not that other thing. Some people would give you like an idea about reading a newspaper. Reading a newspaper, nothing gives to you. Reading any, because you are not interested with writing English, documented English. You are interested with the spoken English. So conversational English only you need to master. So if there is a four lakh English words are there, and you need to only master 10,000 or 1,000 words only, some sentences only. That's very easy, no? You need not to study all words present in the dictionary and unused phrases that is available in the newspaper. So in this sentences, you can see like two-word sentence, three-word sentence, one-word sentence, and so on. You can keep mastering. Day by day, you can start using in the real life. Day by day, your system will understand and start learning this English from subconscious, unconsciously. It start learning. See, look at this. Says, how could such a little girl steal your money? When you are amateur, start from one word sentence, two word sentence, three word sentence, four way sentence. Because if it is a long sentence, you are not able to learn it. You are not able to master it. You are not able to learn it speedily, in speed. Okay. So this is what you need to understand. And how about novels? How about novels? If you read a novel, it will give you the idea about the conversational English only. Why not? The comics also very interesting thing that consists of a conversational English. See, look at this. So I'm simply giving one of the comic, Tinkle comics, which is very popular. But there are plenty of other comics also available. Or if possible, you can go with other English novels. Any one of the English novel you can take and you can read it out. Read it out. Read it out in the sense so that your tongue get familiar. Look at this here. That conversational English. If you want arms, prove that you are really blind. Can you see the tree? Sure, I can. Well, I can't. You poor man. Here is a coin for you. See, look at this. How we have to utter it. You should keep practicing. Then day by day, gradually, you start mastering fluency English. See, these type of plenty of comics are readily available. You can get it through digital, that is from Google itself, and you can start read it out. You are hot all over. So you now learn something, because this is a daily conversation only. You are hot all over. Then I think I have fever, my child. Go fetch a doctor. Go bring a doctor. Right? I will go at once. See, this one very important. At once means immediately. So when you start learning a particular sentence, what it really does, it will give you the another idea also. That a particular word at once can be used with other sentences also. And you can read it out. Why did you put that red hot iron into the water, sir? When you read it out, you should read it broken. Why did you put that red hot iron into the water, sir? To cool it. To cool it. See how cold it has become. If water can cool a red hot iron so fast, why not? Right? So guys, so this is what my ideas about what is the problem with the traditional spoken English and why all your effort taken irrespective of your matriculation school, whatever your English knowledge may be, why you failed to speak in English. So to conclude, the area one need to concentrate, I can give you the idea, is very simple. Teaching your tongue and speech rhythm. Teaching your tongue and speech rhythm is essential. Say for an example, speech rhythm in the sense, if you are here, you have to read it. See how cold it has become. So this is what you need to practice in your home daily. If water can cool a red hot iron so fast, why not? Why did you put that red hot iron into the water, sir? See, how you speak, this is how you have to practice. Would you, could you, I will, I shall I, may I? These are all the thing that you need to do that. Fluency in telephone English and sectoral English. So some particular sentences are frequently used in a telephone. Say for an example, hang up, hang on, hold, right? Wait, can you be a bit louder? Right? Can I take a message? He's not available here. May I call you later? These are all particular sentences that are frequently used. You guys has to learn it. That's what I said in Google itself. You can give like a telephone conversational English. If you give, you will get a plenty of things. You can start read it out. How to deal with this hesitation? See, what people really think in the sense, speech means without a hesitation, they think like they have to speak very fast. That's what the problem comes, hesitation comes. Okay, so you can use like words per minute. You can, if you are not able to speak very fast, suppose some struggle comes, what you can do is you can pause it. You can see CM, PM, those people are use number of words per minute. In the particular words per minute, what they used to do, they used to pause in a regular interval, so that they regain, they overcome that fast problem. If you most of the people think like speaking fast in English is a skill, but that's not true. Spoken English does not expect such things. Even the native English speaker also don't speak in this way. They pause if there is anything. So how to deal with the hesitation, in the sense pausing in the right place is important. If you don't know any word, any sentence to speak, you can pause. That is a good idea. Oral training in fluency vocabulary is most important. Oral training in fluency vocabulary is most important. It is not to learn them specifically, but to add them to your conscious or subconscious mind so that they can be used later. Right? Next, impromptu speech flow techniques. In the sense, when you write a sentence, you should write it grammatically in orderly fashion. But in speaking, you need not to use orderly fashion. You can use an impromptu speech flow. Say for an example, when does the bus come? The bus when will come? The bus when comes? Something you can use. That's what impromptu speech flow techniques. Next, fluency building and mouth gymnastics. Fluency building and mouth gymnastic techniques. These techniques are most important, particularly mouth gymnastic techniques are most important. That thing can easily be done repeatedly. You are reading the sentence. Let me give you the one assignment. Please try to do at the time you come to know about why speaking is important. See, when you start speaking, your air will ask the word, and it get trained itself. But if you don't speak, your air also not getting practiced. So if you start reading out louder and doing fluency building and mouth gymnastics, what you can do is afterwards you go and see like 24/7 and some CNN news channel. After your practice, you can go and see the channel and you can be able to understand what they are reading, what their news reader reads. But before that, you can see like whatever they read, you are not able to understand. So your tongue as well as ear work coordinatively. Fluency in speaking about the people. So speaking about the people conversation, you can give in Google and you can start doing. Fluency in asking questions. See, this is very important. In day-to-day life, a real conversation is built up of question and answering. You can see people always speaking in a question and answer manner only. Where are you? Where were you? Where have you been? Had your food? Yes. Where have you been? I went to so-and-so. What's your name? Question. Answer. I am so-and-so. Which standard you are studying? What happens? What will happen? question and answering only. In real world, the conversation happens. So what you need to do is, wherever question and the answer comes, you need to give more attention. That's what art of questioning is vital. So to conclude, the area one need to concentrate is fluency and moment-to-moment speech production. So when you read a sentence, you should not read a sentence as a whole. You should be read as chunk by chunk manner. See, when you come to the Supandi case here, look at this. I will go at once. I will fetch at once. I will bring at once. You should not read it out. I will go at once. And one, instead, you have to read like, I will go at once. Okay. So afterwards, you can change like, I will fetch. I will bring at once. So that's what this sentence says, like moment to moment speech production. Okay. Fluency in topic wise English. These are all some of the topics that you need to master, because this is what we are speaking in a regular interval. Say, for an example, driving, vehicle repairs and maintenance, cloth, weather, money, entertainment, leisure, sports and games. These are all important topic wise English that you need to master. Say, for an example, suppose you want to master, then you can give like sports and games. Topic-wise, sports and games, conversational English. If you give in Google, it will bring you a plenty of sentences. You can start read it out. And fluency and pronunciation. Words being clustered or grouped together. A particular sentence is clustered, right? Sentences are grouped. English learners must realize is that words are not perfectly pronounced and spaced when native speakers speak. See, you should not think like I should speak in Pakka English. No, you try to speak in a normal English. Day by day, gradually, automatically, your system will help you to bring a Pakka English. Okay, then if you want a style in English, you need not to train. Just to put it in your mind will take care of the style. Okay. And one more technique that I am going to tell you is, you can use lyrics, English lyrics, no? That English lyrics you can use along with the song and try to sing. Say, for an example, let me try one method. Say, for an example, I am interested with the Billie Jean, Michael Jackson song. Billie Jean lyrics. See, this is a Billie Jean lyrics. I can go to YouTube. Billie Jean song. Okay. What I can do is, I can make it play. She was more like a beauty queen from a movie scene. I said, don't mind, but what do you mean? I am the one who will dance on the floor in the round. She said, I am the one who will dance on the floor in the round. She told me her name was Billie Jean. As she was a scene, Then every head turned with eyes that dreamed of being the one who will dance on the floor in the round. So in this way, what you can do is you can take any of the song lyrics and you can play the play the song and you can go along with it. That will day by day your tongue will get suppled with those information and you can master English. So this is what my techniques, some of the techniques. So to conclude, so what we discussed in the sense. So from broken English to spoken English or fluent English, tips and techniques, secrets revealed. I said, like, what is the tradition? Why the traditional method fails, like spoken English class, as well as that matriculation school methodology fails, and how to overcome such a problem. In such a problem, what you need to do is daily, day-to-day conversational English only, you should get familiar and your tongue should get familiar. So you need to do the speech rhythm practice day by day. One of the method is movie subtitles is the very good method, as well as comics, novels are the very good one. Wherever you see conversational English, read it loud. And another one is go for lyrics. Open the lyrics and play the song and song along with it day by day. If you gradually your skill set gradually keep increasing and you will master the English. Thanks for watching.